The mega solar plant that will be constructed by Masdar shall be established in Bolamboli district and will be added onto the national grid to address power shortage issues. Nabanja, while speaking after the signing ceremony, says that this investment will offer cheap power, which is clean energy, and will accelerate development in the country.
On behalf of the president, I have witnessed the signing of an agreement between the government of Uganda and Masdar, a company here that is starting a roadmap to produce 150 megawatts in eastern Uganda, which power will be added on the national grid so that we can develop our country.
We cannot begin the development of all the 1,000 because it will require, first of all, to do the grid study to see whether our national grid can take on all the 1,000 megawatts. So today we have, the premise has witnessed the roadmap for the first 150 megawatts.
Judith Nabakova, the Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development, says that her ministry will work closely with the Ministry of Energy to have the project started as soon as possible.
As Uganda, we are ready and we welcome this project by Masdar to Uganda, and we shall support it when it comes to the requirements of land.
Mohammed Jamel Al-Ramahi, who represented the company, says that they are ready to start the project implementation for the good of the two sister countries.
We at Masdar, who are working closely with Uganda Ministry of Energy, are committed to develop this project as per the timelines. And we, of course, are also happy to provide support from a technical aspect related to the grid.
Masdar is a government-owned corporation and one of the world's largest renewable energy companies and a green hydrogen leader, placing the United Arab Emirates at the forefront of the energy transition. Masdar is active in more than 40 countries across 6 continents and has invested or committed to invest in worldwide projects with a combined value of more than $30 billion. In a related development, the Prime Minister met Nail and Bin Hamal Hydro Export LLC, an infrastructure company that wants to invest in Uganda. Nabanja briefed the potential investor that Uganda has a favorable investment environment and asked him to come and invest in Uganda. Nabanja says that Uganda serves as a business hub in East and Central Africa.
Development Index as of 2022-2023. Mm-hmm. We are 7.5.
Wow. It's remarkable.
Now, all this is favored by the market. We have the East African market, which is 330 million people. We have the African Free Trade Area, which is 1.5 billion people. And you can have repatriate your profits. UAE. That's why.
Engineer Hani T. Saliba, the company's building division director, says that they are willing to invest in Uganda.
Very versatile company, and we work in many sectors, so it can be a very good collaboration. And we see ourselves as partners in any country we work with, because at the end of the day, we're not there to take and siphon out. We are there to invest and reinvest and reinvest.
Nail and Bin Hamal Hydro Export LLC has undertaken and successfully executed multiple large-scale government and private sector projects in the United Arab Emirates and the MENA region with a paid-up capital of more than 1 United Arab Emirates dirham billion to support project requirements. And the MENA region with a paid-up capital of more than 1 billion United Arab Emirates dirham to support project requirements. Story compiled by Ismail Kasoha for the news.